Hi everyone, I am Enchong Dee and I am your friendly budgetarian and you're listening to my podcast. Hey everyone, today we will be discussing about building an emergency fund because it's very timely and it's not usually being talked about in the mainstream media. And now, I think with all that's happening, we have a viral outbreak. We have recently a volcanic eruption. There are activated earthquakes all over the world. Merong banta ng World War III na knock on wood. Typhoons na paparating since we're starting a year. So, with everything that's happening in the world right now, calamities and viral outbreaks, it's a reminder that so much is uncertain. We never know when a disaster or sickness will strike. Totoo naman, kasi minsan katulad nung bago ako umalis for my holidays, nagpa-check up lang ako, pero nag-end yung araw ko, na-confine ako sa hospital. So parang saan nang galing yun, di ba? But again, ito yung mga pagkakataon na hindi mo inaasahan, pero all of a sudden, biglang kakailanganin mo ng budget. We all need to be prepared financially. We do this by creating an emergency fund. But what is an emergency fund? Emergency fund is a money you set aside for something unexpected. For your health, for like a calamity, or may nangailangan. Lalo na, again, sa bansa natin, minsan yung emergency fund nagagaling kay ninong, kay ninang, kay ate, kay kuya, kay tita, kay tito. So, minsan tayo kailangan din natin mag-emergency fund para hindi natin nababother yung mga ibang tao. A good rule of thumb is to have a 6 months worth of your living expenses. Let's talk about that. Paano natin ito maho-compute? Okay, siguro look at a modest amount of your everyday expenses. Everyday expenses, yung pagkain mo. Doon manggagaling yung bulk ng emergency fund mo. Yung titirhan mo. How much is your usual electricity bills, phone bills, water bills, so yung bills? Ito, makukompute mo to by being mindful of your monthly expenses from where you are right now. Kaya natin sinasabi na importante that you track your expenses, na ilista mo yung mga expenses mo. Sometimes it's such an effort for a lot of people, lalo na kung hindi ka naman usually mindful sa mga expenses mo. But trust me, it will help you. Yung pagkain, yung bills, yung titirahan, your transportation, yung mga kailangan mo para mabuhay comfortably in the next 6 months. Or kung hindi masyado doable sa iyo yung 6 months, 3 months. And hindi mo to kaya, hindi mo siya pwedeng gawin na, okay, in a month time or in 6 months time. Usually, emergency funds, you accumulate it throughout the years. Usually, 2 to 5 years. So, it's better if you start now. Sa ibang tao kasi, what they would do is 50% necessities, 30% taxes, bills, payments, and yung 20% is for your savings and your emergency fund. Minsan mahirap na i-compartmentalize siya na ganun lang kasi iba-iba naman yung kita natin, iba-iba naman yung pangangailangan natin. So what you do, the healthiest way is to accumulate it habang walang nangyayari. Like, start now. As simple as, okay, I'm gonna set aside 500 pesos. Every time you have an extra money, save that for your emergency fund. And I'm telling you, emergency fund is different from your savings, ha? Dapat you're not supposed to be confused with that. Because yung savings, it's for your future. Emergency fund is for something unexpected. And those are two different things. It's good to understand also that emergency fund is not just for the rich. We can all create one. Typically, if you go online, sasabihin nila you have to, you know, set aside 20% of your income into savings and then 10% into emergency fund. And normally, that will build over 2 to 5 years to your to get your 6 months worth of emergency fund. But I think that's too long, or you'll end up using those funds before they even get built. So nag-set aside ako ng tips. We will discuss that later. But what is the importance of emergency fund? Yun, katulad kanina, sinabi natin, baka mamaya biglang matanggal tayo sa trabaho. Knock on wood, it's constantly happening, not only here in the Philippines, but all over the world. So kapag nawalan ka ng trabaho, you need an emergency fund to get by while you're looking for your next job. It can be used for transportation, acquiring requirements, and going to interviews. Because guys, this will cost you, looking for your next job. It's good that you have that, you know, funds where you can pull out some funds. Medical emergencies. Katulad nung sinasabi ko, can I share a photo of me while talking about this? So, ito yung naging itsura ko. Nagpa-check up lang ako for my tuhod. And then, this is how I ended up looking. Anyway, I'm just gonna share it. So, this is me. Mabilis na mabilis lang. So, yun. Nagpa-check up ako. Bigla na lang akong, all of a sudden, nasa ER ako. So, saan ko kukunin yun? Wala naman siya sa expenses ko for that month na bigla akong mako-confine. So, at least kahit papano meron akong savings in my ATM which I can pay for the emergency room happenings. I really, really hope that we have a medical care here in the Philippines na sobrang ganda. But we don't. We really have to take care of ourselves. So, guys, please do be mindful about your health also. That's very important. Another thing is unexpected home and car repair. You know, disasters and inevitable. Ito yung mga hindi natin inaasahan. Like, for example, yung lindol or yung typhoon. Minsan, nananahimik yung bahay nyo. Bigla na lang may sunog or bigla na lang may baha. Na ito yung mga kailangan ng repairs. And dahil nga, hindi mo naman inaasahan. Wala namang may gusto na mangyari to. Then, you have to have that emergency fund. I listed some tips that may help everyone mag-build ng emergency fund. So, I'm telling you, as much as possible, para hindi rin mahirap, huwag mo munang kunin yung pang-save mo sa emergency fund from your income. Number one, sell something. Look around the house. You'll be surprised at how many times you could convert some things into cash. Like, for example, yung pinaglumaan na toys na okay naman. Barely used appliances, Diyos ko, napakarami, that just are there in your house, naka-clutter, nakatago, hindi naman ginagamit. Or furniture, like an old sofa, or like a table, a chair, you know. Your trash can be someone else's treasure, and that can be monetized. We also have your bags, your clothes, and shoes. I experienced my highest earnings from bazaar. 3-day bazaar. Lagay mo yung mga gamit na napaglakihan mo na, napaglumaan mo na, yung mga still okay pero hindi mo na kailangan. I was able to earn 100,000 in 3 days. So, 100,000 is a huge amount na declutter ko na yung bahay namin. At the same time, you have this 100,000 and 100,000 can be put into your emergency fund. These are the things na hindi mo naman inaasahan that you will earn. So saan mo siya gagamitin? If you don't have an emergency fund, prioritize that. Kung meron ka namang bagay na paglalaanan ng mga napagbentahan mo, there's another tip. Number 2 is finding your one-time gig or yung mga tinatawag nating mga racket. Kasi itong mga racket na to, hindi mo naman talaga to main income. Hindi naman talaga ito yung main cash cow mo. So, every now and then, meron kang ways kung paano makakakuha ng mga racket. You can participate in a survey or a focus group or like yung mga, minsan kailangan nila ng study. So, maghahanap sila ng mga tao na kailangan maging part ng study na to. And they will give you a certain amount. A certain honorarium, and you know that amount, save that. Just recently I used this app. This is not a paid partnership, but since it's very helpful, download Gawin. If you're not familiar with this one, it's an app that they hire someone for a one-time job, like installing something or cleaning something or help someone to assemble a party or create a party. So no matter what skills you have, you can sign up and list what you can do for the price you want. So yung Gawin app is more of like, okay, this is my expertise. Like for example, I'm good at swimming. I can teach someone to swim. One way or another, one day may mga kailangan na lang that will go to the app and sasabihin nila, okay, I need someone who can be a lifeguard for my kids' party, someone to just look there, and someone who can attend to all the guests while they're swimming, just to keep everyone safe. And they will pay you. So, ako naman, I have the expertise of swimming and I have the expertise of basic life-saving. Then I can, suggest myself and present myself na, ako po, marunong po ako. And how much can you earn that? Like 3,000 or 5,000 for one day? Try to go to that app and, it's either ikaw yung mangangailangan ng expertise ng ibang tao or you can offer your expertise to other people. And that will go to your racket. And I'm sure lahat kayo, meron kayong expertise. 1, 2, 3. I'm sure you have. All of us have. If you're a social media influencer, you can post something, di ba? This is the time. This is a good time for you to be alive because you will use your social media accounts to promote something. But be responsible with the things you promote also, I'm telling you. But at the same time, if you're proud of something and if you believe in a certain product or a certain movement, post that. And, this company, this brand constantly look for influencers and it might be you, di ba? Number 3, if you can get a second job, kung hindi naman mahirap na magkaroon ka ng second job, like a weekender job, di ba? I know none of us likes the thought of pulling extra hours away from our families and for that much longer. But even just for 4 weeks of an extra job can make a huge difference. Imagine, di ba sinasabi ko kanina, it'll take time for you to accumulate that good amount of emergency funds, like 2 to 5 years. But if you have this kind of rackets, if you have this second job, I think you can build your emergency fund in a 4 weeks second job type. Hindi mo kailangan ilagay yung sarili mo sa isang trabaho na hindi mo naman talaga gusto or na set aside mo sa utak mo na, okay, 4 weeks ko lang siya gagawin or 2 weeks ko lang siya gagawin just to build your emergency fund. Kasi usually tayo, hindi naman natin siya maiisip kapag okay tayo. Diba? Kapag walang calamity, kapag may trabaho tayo, kapag maganda yung buhay, hindi natin ito naiisip. But once it gets in front of you, at least ready ka. Ito yung mga proud moments mo na, okay, I have an extra fund for my parents, for taking care of them. Hindi mo kailangan galawin yung savings mo and yung mga hard-earned money mo because may mga nangyari lang sa'yo. So, guys, eto, necessity to. Think about it. And kung okay ka naman ngayon, kung you have your savings, you have your job, save something for the future. Save something for your emergency needs, di ba? We have additional tips on how to build an emergency fund. Maybe you guys can get something from it. I'll just run it down. Number 1, set up a saving system. A good example for, katulad nga nung sinasabi namin yung scheme kanina na 50-30-20. But feel free to do your own system. Because again, bawat isa sa atin has their different income, has a different background, different environment that they live in. So feel free as long as it works for you. Number 2, cut down your expenses, but this is arguable, without depriving yourself with the good stuff. Number 3, increase your earning capacity, again, with the racket, with the second job. And number 4, track your spending. Guys, please be mindful of your spending because this will not only help you in one way, marami siya from educating yourself, controlling yourself, handling your finances, to building your emergency fund. So, as simple as tracking your spending in a weekly basis goes a long way. So, that's it. Guys, that's all the time we have for today. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell for updates on my latest uploads. Also, follow me on my other social media accounts like Instagram at Mr_EnchongDee and Twitter at EnchongDee777. See you next episode. I hope you learn a lot. See you guys. Mwah.